Hello, I'm Shelley Broder, and I'm your host for What's Happening AHS. This program is to inform you of the student activities around Attleboro High School. And now, here's my co-host, Kim Ward.
Hello. The varsity faculty volleyball game will be held Wednesday, October 16th at 7 p.m. in the Big Gym. Tickets are available from team members for $1 or $1.50 at the door.
For sophomores, there is a mandatory meeting for council members in room 210A after school on Wednesday. And here's a note from P.T. Salito to all student council members. Due to the varsity faculty volleyball game, the meeting will be held from 6 to 7:15. Please try to be on time.
For you seniors, Inland Bay Cable, Channel 39, is carrying two SAT preparation programs, Math Review and Verbal Review. You can pick up these programs in your guidance office.
If you would like to be a part of the Spirit Rally Tug of War, please submit your name and weight to Ms. Salito by Friday, October 18th. The names will be drawn at random on that day.
Also, PSATs will be given Saturday, the 19th, for juniors and interested sophomores. Registration deadline is Thursday the 10th. And the video club will be having a meeting to elect officers on October 21st after school in the Resource Center. New members are welcome, and we hope to see you there.
Okay, well, it's time for us to sign off now. Hope to see you next week with our newly expanded program. And in closing, here are some highlights of Saturday's Car Wash, sponsored by Students Against Driving Drunk.
Thank you.
SAD organization from the high school, which is Students Against Driving Drunk.
And today we'd like to share some sad facts with you today,
which we were passing out at the drive-up because we're having a car wash at McDonald's. Okay, Someone is killed by a drunk driver every 23 minutes.
Injury from alcohol-caused crashes is teenagers' number one health problem today.
Teenage passengers show a high death rate starting at the age of 13.
The 16 to 24 age group causes 44% of nighttime fatal alcohol-caused crashes.
6 out of 10 people who kill themselves in a single vehicle accident is drunk.
In the 16 to 24-year-old age group, alcohol is responsible for 8,000 deaths a year and the disfiguring of 40,000 young people today.
Out of 60 children born today, one will die and three will be gravely injured in a car accident related to alcohol. This will happen before their 20th birthday.
Drunk driving will kill 70 people alone today and injure 2,150 more.
Please don't drink and drive.
Thank you.
My name is Shelley Broder, and I'm your host for What's Happening AHS. This is the first edition of our newly expanded program, so at the end, you will see highlights of student activities that have happened since our last show. And now, here's my wonderful co-host, Kim Ward.
Hello. This show is really going to be good, so stay tuned. Interviews for the jobs for Bay State Graduates Program will continue until the end of October. House 2 and 3 will be receiving passes to go for their interviews. Any of you in House 1 who hasn't already had their interviews and still wish to join this program, stop by and see Mrs. Giles as soon as possible.
Attention to all students. Yearbook sales will be starting November 1st, and the cost is $19. You may put down a $10 deposit in the yearbook office during homeroom.
and seniors, baby pictures may be brought to the yearbook office from room, or room 224B. Come on, you guys, and show your cute little face. Right, Shel?
Right, Kim. Freshman class officers and representatives will meet Wednesday after school in room 148D to plan for the fundraiser. Good luck, freshmen.
Students are reminded not to use the third floor of the resource center at any time of the day.
Well, that's our show for this week. This has been What's Happening AHS. Please stay tuned for some of the highlights of student activities. I'm Shelley Broder.
And I'm Kim Ward.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Lisa Kilfoyle. I'm reporting for the Academics Newsbeat. This evening, we would like to present a talk about the American Revolutionary Soldier, given by Dennis Ingalls of the 11th Regiment. This program is sponsored by the Attleboro High School U.S. History Department, made up of Ms. Salito, Mr. Buca, and Mr. Bonneville. Thank you.
Stage we have strutted our art and acted our parts to the best of our power. That the farce had concluded not perfectly well. As surely the fault of the devil in hell.
Derry down, 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 derry down.
The other purpose for the stock was to prevent the man's throat from being slashed with a saber or punctured with a bayonet. The hat that I'm wearing is called a military cocked hat. It's not perfectly triangular in shape. It's cocked off to the left. And then it is worn even further off to the left. The side piece comes way into the back. Reason for that is the length of the musket. If I were to shoulder the musket and wear the hat perfectly straight, I would knock my hat off. The glasses that I have on are a good representation of the period. These here in particular are about 160 plus years old. It's a very fine wire frame. Lenses here are my own. I have to wear glasses. And again, we strive for authenticity, so most of the current glasses you have today could not be worn. Some other examples of glasses of the period. Again, very fine wireframe. The lens area in these are a little bit bigger than the ones I have on. These also would wrap around the ears, which would help hold them on. And this pair has a square lens, rectangular lens. The unique part about these is the sidearms expand. They slide. Now, if you wore these, you tie a ribbon in one side of this, put them on, bring your ribbon around the back of your hand, and tie it on the other side. That would hold the glasses on. Other than that, they just simply fall off. Carrying a cartridge box. It's a leather pouch. It has a wooden block on the inside. There are 20 holes drilled in that block that carry 20 rounds of ammunition. Two pieces hanging down from the cartridge block are called a pick and a brush. These are used to clean the musket. Black powder is a very dirty substance. The musket becomes fouled, may not fire. Very important to the soldier. On this side, I have a canteen. This one's made of wood. Serves the purpose very well, unless you let it dry up. The wood will shrink, the canteen will leak. Another example of a canteen, it's made of metal. More or less carried by the British. Didn't have to worry about them drying up and possibly shrinking like the wood. What you had a problem with here is rusty water. But at least the man had one.
We stand after the fee. If folks were on land and churches on sea, if Otis were man and if Ross at the cause, if Cass should be chased into holes while Mars, if
Attleboro High School Vocal Ensemble again. We've been here before and we decided we'd like to come back. It's our first trip out this year. So you're our first audience and we picked our best audience for our first because we remembered what a good time we had here last time. We're going to sing some new songs and we're going to sing some songs that I hope you'll recognize and I hope you'll sing along with us with a Happy Foot or something. First song we're going to do is You Are My Sunshine.
A look at the sports. Hi, I'm Lisa Kilfoyle. Right now I'd like to give you the scores of last week's games. Friday, girls swim team beat Durfee. Varsity soccer lost to Dartmouth 5-1. Varsity football lost to Somerset 28-7. Varsity field hockey lost to Barnstable 3-1. And right now I'll tell you next week's game so that everyone will be there to cheer them on. Thursday, we have the JV and varsity soccer team against Stang at 3:15. Friday, girls swim team at New Bedford at 3:30. Friday, cross country all-conference meeting at 3. Friday, also, we have the varsity football team against Stang at 7 p.m. And Monday, JV football team against Coyle Cassidy, 3:15. And JV and varsity field hockey at Somerset, 3:15. Also, JV cheerleading tryouts will be held next Friday, November 1st at 3 p.m. in the girls' gym. To sign up for this, go to the pit area Thursday and Friday, and then practices will be held Monday through Thursday of next week after school in the pit. Well, that's all the sports for today. Thank you for joining me. I'm Lisa Kilfoyle. Have a nice night. We'll be right back.
Hello, my name is Shelley Broder.
And I'm Kim Wood.
And this is What's Happening AHS. Well, folks, this week is Spirit Week at Attleboro High School, and each day has its own dress code. Today is Hawaiian Ski Day, and Kim and I decided to get dressed up for the occasion. Thursday is Costume Day, and Friday is Blue and White Day. We now have a tape to show you of Monday and Tuesday's costumes.
What do you guys think of Spirit Week?
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah! Give it up.
Alright.
Give me.
What?
Please don't.
I want to scrape your blood.
Oh, God.
Just scrape it around.
Hello, welcome back. I hope you enjoyed those clips. For our first piece of news today, we'd like to congratulate Jim Cotty, who was the Attleboro High School's Century Third Leadership competitor. He will now advance to the state-level competitions. Congratulations, Jim, and good luck in the state level.
Good luck, Jim. Students are reminded that the deadline for registration for the December 7th SAT Achievement Test closes on Friday, November 1st. After this date, there is a late registration fee of $11.50. You can obtain information from your guidance counselors. And now, a commercial break.
Hello? Hi.
I've got it. Let's meet in our usual spot.
Okay, I'll be there in a little while. Okay, bye. Thank you.
Up there to give you this, Kim.
Oh, what is it? Oh, thanks. How'd you know I wanted one of these?
Well, when we were in the school store, you said you liked it.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Oh, I love it. Should I try it on?
Sure, I can. I wasn't sure if it was the right size or not.
It's wicked nice. Oh, thanks. It's great.
Who have not registered for the November 2nd administration of the SAT ACH test and still wish to do so should see Mrs. Busby in House 1 Guidance Office. The cost for taking the SAT test will be $36.50. The cost for taking the achievement test will be $43.50. These fees are payable only by check, not by cash. Now remember, the cost is only for late registration only.
T.D. Brown Studios will be here Friday, November 1st, photographing student groups all day. Please consult the photography schedule, which is being passed out during homeroom on Thursday and Friday.
And the school store is now selling Lana the Frog. Buy one for your favorite holiday. Halloween Lana is on sale now for $3.25.
And now, here are some clips from activities around the school. We'll be right back.
Thank you. Kathy McCormick.
And I'm Jennifer Peters.
And we're standing here on the banks of a river with Mr. McDonald in his class. Mr. McDonald, how long have you been doing this sort of project?
About 25 years.
That's a long time. 25 years.
A lot of stuff in here.
Yes. Do they dig up stuff that's been left here from other classes?
Yes. They try and figure out if it was anything to do with a lost civilization.
What do you accomplish from
it? It shows them how hard it is for the archaeologists to find stuff. I mean, even though this was just buried yesterday, they've only got maybe 25% of the stuff that's buried.
My name is Paul Cochran, and I'm the freshman class secretary. This year, the freshman class will be selling records, tapes, and magazines. This money will go towards activities for the freshman class. So remember, when we come to your door, please buy a subscription. Remember, freshmen, get out there and sell these magazines so we can have a great year. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Lisa Kilfoyle, and I'm your host for AHS Locker Room. And here's my co-host, Erin Geddes.
Hi, AHS Locker Room is a program to give you the scores in the upcoming sports events of Attleboro High School.
The results of last week's games are girls swim team tied New Bedford 86-86, varsity football lost to Stain 29-14,
varsity volleyball beat Coyle Cassidy 16-14 and 15-8. The varsity field hockey team lost to Somerset 5-0.
Now for our upcoming games.
Friday, we have the varsity and JV soccer team versus Conley at 3:15 p.m. Saturday, the cross-country coaches meet at 3 p.m. And also Saturday, we have the varsity football game at Falmouth, 2 p.m.
Also, Sunday, the juniors and seniors will battle it out in the annual Powder Puff game.
I know who I want to win.
Me too. Well, that's our show for tonight. I'm Lisa Kilfoyle.
And I'm Erin Geddes. We'll see you next time on AHS Locker Room. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, that's what's happening for this week. Coming up next week, you'll see clips from Friday's rally, student council, pep squad, powder puff, and other activities from around the school. I hope you've enjoyed our show. I'm Shelley Broder.
And I'm Kim Ward.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome to What's Happening AHS. I'm your host, Shelley Broder. We had planned to bring you a story explaining why Powder Puff was postponed, but as we found out this morning, it has been canceled. The senior class advisors are the one who made this decision, and so the juniors win by forfeit. And now, here's my co-host, Kim Ward, with Hello. More news.
Hello. For our first notice today, seniors are reminded that late registration for the December 7th administration of the Scholastic Aptitude Test and Achievement Test closed on November 13th. If you need a registration bulletin, you should see your counselor.
Seniors, remember, prom money is due on Friday, November 8th. The full payment is $50 and is due at this time.
1986 yearbooks are now on sale in the yearbook office. Your yearbooks cost $19, and a $10 deposit may be made during homeroom or B or C lunch.
Selection for the jobs for Bay State Graduate Program will be completed Friday, November 8th. A list of seniors will be available in each house office on November 12th. The orientation will be Thursday, November 14th, during periods 3 and 4.
The TV broadcasting Explorers Post will hold its first informational meeting tonight, November 7th, at 7 to 9 at WARA, 8 North Main Street. Everyone is welcome. Scenes from this meeting will be shown on next week's show.
There's a big button sale going on in B2 Cafeteria during all lunches on Friday, November 8th. Come on and design your own button.
There will be a meeting for all girls interested in the girls' gymnastics team on Wednesday, November 13th at 2:10 in room 156D.
The Varsity Booster Club, along with Students Against Driving Drunk, is sponsoring a dance this Saturday from 7:30 to 11 at the Attleboro Armory. Come on out and have a good time. Here's a reminder from Mr. Roussel about the ski trip to Killington, Vermont. This ski trip is not a school-sponsored activity, and the sponsors are unknown. Just a reminder, it is not a school-sponsored activity.
Okay. Stay seated and watch the following Attleboro High School clips.
Hi, welcome to AHS Locker Room. I'm your host, Lisa Kilfoyle, and here's my co-host, Erin Geddes.
Hi, AHS Locker Room is a program to give you the scores in the upcoming games of Attleboro High School.
The Powder Puff game, which was rescheduled to Wednesday, November 13th, has now been forfeited by the seniors. Due to this, the juniors will hold the banner at the Thanksgiving game for most spirited class.
The varsity football team lost to Falmouth 28-0. Their next game will be against Durfee at 1:30 Saturday at Tozier Cassidy Field.
As the fall season draws to an end, we're receiving the final records for fall sports. The girls' swim team holds an outstanding record of 9 wins, 1 loss, and 1 tie.
The varsity soccer team holds a record of 5 wins, 7 losses, 5 ties. The record of the varsity field hockey team, who stepped into a more difficult division this season, ends with 1 win, 13 losses, and 2 ties. The varsity volleyball team holds a record of 7 wins, 11 losses.
Well, that's all the time we have for tonight. I'm your host, Lisa Kilfoyle.
And I'm your co-host, Erin Geddes. We'll see you next time on AHS Locker Room.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
And I'm Jennifer Peters from TV production class.
We are here at Attleboro High School to show you the reactions of the students, parents, and staff about Parents Night. Also tonight, we hope to give you some insight on what Parents Night really is. Thank you.
Anybody down there, let me know?
Talk with President of Student Council and Vice President of Student Council, Jim St. Pierre and Susan Jenks. Jim, what do you think about Parents Night?
I think it's a good way for the parents of each student to get to know and to realize their child's growth in each class.
Teachers really can't tell too much to the parents because it's only been a month of school. But the parents just get to meet who their child sees every day.
So you think it's good having a parents night? You think it's worth our while?
I think it is. I think parents get to see that we don't necessarily have three heads like the kids have told them, that the parents don't necessarily have three heads either. I think it's a chance to learn what the expectations of the class are, to learn what the requirements of a particular teacher are, and to learn how the class will be evaluated and graded.
Could you summarize in one word what you think about Parents Night?
No, I couldn't. I could do it in two words.
Okay, words.
Potentially useful.
Thank you.
I wish I could turn people back to that.
Yeah. It really makes a difference.
So you think it's worth our while to come here tonight?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Oh, it's probably the single best population
in one word, could you summarize for us your opinion of
I think it is worthwhile. It's very busy.
Okay. Hi. We're the president of Vice President. I'm the vice president. He's the president. He's not doing anything.
My name is Jennifer Peters.
And I'm Kathy McConnick.
And we're here with Mr. Bray, the principal of Attleboro High School.
Mr. Bray, how do you feel about Parents Night?
How do I feel about Parents Night? Well, I think it's a great night. I mean, you can see people all be relaxed. They're walking around for the most part. They're having a chance to meet new teachers. And it looks like they're having a very favorable impression. You know, I've been doing this for a long time. And I get very, very few complaining parents. The parents seem to enjoy it. I think the teachers seem to enjoy it. I think teachers probably enjoy it more than anybody, because after working with the students all day, they like having a chance to meet your parents. How do you feel about it? This is your first one. You're a ninth grader. How do you feel about it? What do you think? The way you can see.
I don't know.
You don't know? Okay.
Do you think it's better from Parents Night?
Yeah, I think they do, because I think the more that a parent can associate himself with the school, and the more the parents come into a school setting, and they see cafeteria B1 or B2 or science lab. And then when they go home, I think the more that they have to talk to you about our schooling programs, I think the better off they are.
They can actually go home and discuss
it with you. And we have parent advisory meetings, and we have tours for parents, and we bring parents around the building. And those parents that take advantage of the tours and things, I think they're 100% better off. When, like I said, sitting around the table, there's something they can talk about, and they can relate with you. They know what you're talking about.
And they know the teachers.
Yeah, I wish that every single parent would do something like that.
Can you summarize Parents Night in one word?
Summarize, boy, that's a tough. summarize parents tonight with one word: cooperation.
Thank you for watching What's Happening AHS. I'm Kim Wood.
And I'm Shelley Broder.
Thank you. Welcome to another edition of What's Happening AHS. I'm Kim Ward, and filling in for Shelley Broder, who isn't feeling well today, is Micah Vakin.
Hi, Kim. For sports today, the boys' basketball team will be having a meeting for anyone interested in playing varsity, junior varsity, or freshman basketball for this season. The meeting will be held on Friday, November 15th at 210 in room 227B. Football players should sign up with Mr. Sherman by Friday.
Students interested in journalism, there is a Journalism Explorers Post meeting Thursday, November 14th from 7 to 9 p.m. at the Sun Chronicle office, 34 South Main Street. Everyone is welcome.
Also, Gatra bus tickets are now on sale for $4 in the school department store.
And Western New England College is sponsoring an essay contest for 10th, 11th, and 12th graders. The theme of the contest is Liberty and Justice for All. Specific essay topics and entrance rules are available from Mr. Rice, the Social Studies Department Head, in room 113A.
Seniors, there is a mandatory prom committee meeting November 18th at 205 and 308B.
Well, that's our show for today. Thank you for joining us. Stay seated for the locker room and for a segment of the marching band.
Thank you, Kim.
Yep. Shelley, we hope you feel better.
Thank you. to AHS Locker Room. I'm your host, Lisa Kilfoyle, and here's my co-host, Erin Geddes.
Hi. AHS Locker Room is a program to give you the scores in the upcoming games of Attleboro High School.
Last Saturday, the varsity football team lost to Durfee 28-6.
This Saturday, the football team will host the Varian. Game time is at 1:30 at Toja Cassidy Field. This will be their last game until the match with North Attleboro on Thanksgiving Day. This Saturday is also Senior Day for the players and cheerleaders of the football team.
The girls' gymnastics team held a meeting yesterday for sign-ups. If you are unable to attend this meeting and would still like to be part of the team, see Mr. Martin in the phys ed department. Captain's practice will begin Monday of next week.
Anyone wishing to participate in boys' varsity, junior varsity, or freshman basketball, please contact Mr. Sherman in room 235B.
There will be no varsity cheerleading practice next week at all. Next practice will be Tuesday, November 26th at 5:30 p.m.
There was a meeting Tuesday concerning winter track. Practices will begin on the Monday after Thanksgiving, which is December 2nd. Anyone who cannot attend the meeting, please contact Coach Newman in his room.
Well, that's all the time we have for tonight. I'm your host, Lisa Kilfoyle.
I'm your co-host.
Erin Geddes, we'll see you next time on AHS Locker Room.
Thank you.
See you next week. I'm Kim Wood.
I'm Micah Bacon, filling in for Shelly Broda. And Shelly, I hope you feel better.
Thank you.
Shelly Broder, and welcome to another edition of What's Happening AHS. It's good to be back. And now, here's Kim Ward with the news.
Hi. To begin the notices today, we would like to congratulate Kevin Candelette on his selection to the Southeastern Mass Division I All-Star football team. Also, we'd like to congratulate Bob Bischoff and Bob LaPlante for being selected to the Southeastern Mass Division I All-Star team in cross country. Good going, you guys.
Good going. Students who have not registered for the December 7th administration of the SAT and Achievement Test and wish to do so should see Ms. Busby in House 1 Guidance. The cost for SAT is $36.50 and the Achievement is $43.50. These fees are payable by check only. No cash will be accepted.
The Attleboro Rotary Club is planning to start a Rotary Interact here at Attleboro High. This Interact Club is open to all students, grade 9 through 12. December 3rd, there will be an informational meeting, fourth period, in the mini auditorium. Okay, stay right where you are. We're going to break for a commercial now, but when we come back, Shelly will be here talking with Jim St. Pierre, the president of Student Council. Stay tuned.
We're Lorana Frogs.
We represent the Christmas spirit.
Own one of us.
Available at Attleboro High School Department Store.
Located in the main entrance.
Lorana Frogs will be made for all the
holidays.
Right now, Christmas frogs are just $4.25.
They make great gifts.
Ribbit.
Be wild.
Studio today is Jim St. Pierre, President of Student Council. Welcome, Jim.
Thank you, Shelley.
Okay, Jim, could you tell us a little bit about the canned goods drive going on here at the high school?
Well, it's basically self-explanatory. The students on council try their hardest to get the school kids to bring in extra cans from their house, any goods, and any kind of food that we'll distribute to all the needy in Attleboro, or as many families as we can in Attleboro, make Thanksgiving Day baskets for them.
Okay. What kind of incentive did you have for the kids to bring in cans this year?
What, the school kids or council kids?
Both.
Well, there's not really much you can do except ask them and tell them the reason why we're doing this. Mm-hmm. It's a good cause for the city of Attleboro, and we want to help the city as much as possible.
Okay. How did this project get started?
Well, I'm not sure how it got started. Every year the council does this. It's something that that carries on from year to year, and we just thought it was a good idea, so we decided to keep it.
Okay, it's a pretty good cause. How many, have you gotten a lot of response from people so far?
Oh yeah, we have so many cans that we had to save some so we could give them out for Christmas.
Really?
Yeah,
so. That's really good. Well, thank you, Attleboro, for donating all your cans, and thank you for coming, Jim.
Thank you, Shelley.
And now back to Kim.
Seniors who intend to enroll in post-secondary education next year should attend an assembly in the mini auditorium in order to receive information on financial aid on Tuesday, December 3rd. You go according to house. House 1, period 2, house 2, period 3, house 3, period 4. Also, for juniors and seniors, the armed forces will be holding assemblies in the balcony of the Resource Center by pass only. The list of the dates and periods are located in your guidance office.
The Visual Arts Holiday Sale will be Sunday, December 8th from noon to 4 p.m. in the Visual Arts Center at Attleboro High School. Available will be student and faculty artworks, gifts, and holiday items.
Friday, November 29th, the Varsity Booster Club will be sponsoring a Thanksgiving Day dance at the Armory from 7:30 to 11 p.m. Admission is $3 and IDs are required.
Healthy full poinsettia plants are available in the Work Lab Room 114A. The last day for ordering is December 2nd, and pickup is December 5th and 6th. All proceeds are to benefit the Work Lab Hot House program.
That's our show for this week. But before we go, Shelley and I would like to wish everyone a great Thanksgiving. And we'd like to wish the Attleboro High football team good luck in their game versus North on Thanksgiving Day. Keep Hilda home.
Okay, in closing also, I'd like to thank Kim and her sister Tiffany for the sign that they made back here to show our spirit for Thanksgiving.
Thanks, Shel.
Have a good Thanksgiving.
Bye.
what's happening in AHS. Well, Kim's here to start off the notices today.
Hi, Spirit Week is next week, so you should all get decked out. Monday is Winter Wear Day, Tuesday is Holiday Punk Day, Wednesday is Holiday Spirit Day, Thursday is Holiday Hat Day, and Friday is Red and Green Day.
Okay, for only $1, you can have your picture taken with Santa Claus next Tuesday, December 17th, in B2 during all lunches.
Next week, also on sale in all cafeterias, there will be candy grams on sale. They will be distributed on Thursday.
Once again, Student Council is adopting a family for Christmas. A variety of activities have been set up to raise money for this family. Among the activities are candy grams, pictures with Santa, and a jelly bean guessing contest. Let's help this family have a Merry Christmas. Kim?
Juniors and sophomores who took the PSAT test in October, the score reports are available. See ya. Counselor for them.
Once again, Student Council is adopting a family for Christmas. A variety of activities have been set up to raise money for this family. Among the activities are candy grams, pictures with Santa, and a jelly bean guessing contest. Let's help this family have a Merry Christmas.
Congratulations to the top three sophomores of the Class of 88 fundraisers. The winners were Joe Dorr, Faith Parker, and Tracy Roll.
For juniors, the SAT review classes will begin the Saturday after the Christmas vacation. See your counselor today for registration forms.
Seniors with Commonwealth Scholar applications are reminded that Friday, December 13th, is the deadline for getting the materials to your counselor. If nominated, you will receive up to $1,000 in scholarships.
Students who have had or are planning to have a Boston Globe newspaper route for 3 consecutive years are eligible for up to $5,000 in scholarships for post-high school education. Details are available in the guidance offices.
Okay, that was our show for today. Thank you for watching. Be sure to watch next week for another edition of What's Happening.
Before we say goodbye, we'd like to mention that the Video Club has a production shown every night from 6 to 8. Also, on this day, all of us in television would like to wish Kim Ward a happy sweet 16th birthday.
Thank you.
Okay, well, we'll work on it, okay?
Okay.
GoBot?
Yep.
Okay, have you been good?
Yep.
Okay, so I'm going to bring you GoBot.
Yes.
Okay, you want a treat?
I want a brain Star Wars.
Everybody's got their bottoms, Chris.
I want a brain Star Wars.
There it goes.
Want to come up here and tell me what you want for Christmas?
Okay, let's go.
Way down there. Mike, come back here and sit down.
Right now. With Randy.
Yeah, sit right down.
Yeah.
What
are you asking for?
Whoa, what are you saying?
Yeah.
Okay, you want to come see me next?
Okay.
Can you sit down?
Sit down, honey. Did you see him yet?
Yeah. Keep it at home.
Okay. What'd you tell him you wanted? I want a Star Wars.
You do? Have you been a good boy?
Yeah.
You think he'll bring it to you? Yeah. You want it to him? What else do you want?
Eddie?
You be a good boy, okay? I'm sure he'll bring it to you. Okay, you want a lollipop?
Yeah.
There you go.
Yellow.
Yep, that's yellow.
Oh, yeah. Yellow. Oh, yeah. 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 Yeah
Masters of the universe, all them guys? Yeah. Have you been a good boy?
Yeah.
You think they'll believe you?
Yeah.
Okay, you keep being a good boy. I'm sure he will.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
All right.
Yeah.
Red.
Red? Yeah.
I'll see red.
Who's next?
Me.
You.
Okay.
Keep an eye on it. You're probably going to skin this week.
Have you been a good girl? He's been working on it. Yeah. Okay. You want to
to give you the scores and the highlights of sports at AHS.
Since we've been on break, we have no scores, but we do have highlights of the first 2 weeks of practice for the 6 winter sport teams.
And they are boys gymnastics, girls gymnastics, boys basketball, girls basketball, winter track, and boys swimming.
Let's take a look at those.
As far as our last season, we have 102 kids out and two coaches, so we got people all over the place. Hurdlers in the corridors, shot putters in the gym, weightmen working out, kids on the road, kids on the track, we're all over the place. As far as our season, we should have a good season. We have some outstanding kids coming back. Matt Manlove, third in New England in the high jump. The school record holder in the 600, Adam Newman, Darryl Spikes in the sprints, Ricky Cannata in the shot put, Ted Morrissey in the 1,000, Bobby LaPlante and Bobby Bischoff, all league in the distance running. So we do have a good team coming back, Andy Galasso in the 600 also. What we're really counting on is a lot of sophomores and freshmen to fill in the holes to give us depth, and that's what's really going to make the difference. Also have a girls team, right? And they're improving on last year also. And Ann Lynch in the sprints and high jump, and Kathy Savoy middle distance, Chris Snyder distance are going to be the leaders of that team also. Right? And we're hoping for improvement there.
Okay.
is Cliff Sherman, the head basketball coach at Attleboro High School, and I just want to tell you a little bit about the program for the upcoming season. We have a couple of real holes to fill through graduation, one from Greg Payette, who is the senior captain, and he really ran the show offensively. He was a tremendous ball handler and penetrator and shooter, and his position will be very hard to fill, but it looks like right now Kevin Candelette will have a good chance at that, starting at that position, along with David Naveau and John Dascom. Those will probably fill out the guards. Up in the front court, we're lucky to have some seniors back. We have Dan O'Connell, who will be back for a third year as a starting center. Michael McCutcheon will be back. He is the captain this year, and he'll be a third-year starter at the forward position. And the other forward position right now looks like it'll be senior Sean Brumble. Last year, our record was 5-15. It wasn't a great record, but it was a big improvement over the year before when Attleboro basketball really hit rock bottom with a 1-19 record. This year, we're looking to improve on that record. We're working very hard in practice, and we intend to do the things that are necessary for us to start bringing basketball back to a place in Attleboro where it has been.
Pull these in. Right leg back.
Well, they look good to me.
Yeah, and I hope they all have a good season this year.
Well, that's our show for this week. I'm Erin Geddes.
And I'm Lisa Kilfoyle. And right now, I'd like to wish Kim Ward a happy birthday.
Thank you.
AHS. I'm your host, Shelley Broder. To start off, seniors, be sure to complete and return your class will, which was distributed during homeroom today. Also seniors, the deadline registration for the January 25th SAT is December 20th. The late registration deadline is January 2nd, and there is a late fee of $11.50. Please obtain a registration bulletin from your counselor as soon as possible. And juniors, register now with your counselor for the Saturday SAT review classes, which will begin the first Saturday after Christmas vacation. A men's gold 1986 high school ring has been lost. It has a ring guard and a baseball field insignia with the initials JKG on the side. A reward will be given to anyone who returns the ring to Mr. Bray's office. Again, the student council has adopted a family and is raising money for them by selling candy grams. The family has three children, one 10-year-old boy in a wheelchair, an 8-year-old girl, and an 8-month-old girl. Donations may be made at the Christmas assembly on Friday. You can give them a Merry Christmas through your generosity. Attention Attleboro Career Association members, on Thursday, January 2nd and Friday, January 3rd, you will be celebrating 1986, your graduation year, and the return of Mrs. Giles, who wishes you happy holidays. You are to go at your regularly scheduled time to help celebrate. Any student interested in purchasing a school yearbook should place their order now during homeroom in 224B. A $10 deposit is required. Attention all students. This year's Drama Club Spring Musical will be The Wizard of Oz. Auditions will be held January 8th and 10th at 7 o'clock and January 9th at 2 and 7 in the auditorium. You must prepare one up-tempo tune and or one slow tune from any musical. If you are not doing a song from the Oz, please bring your own sheet music. Production dates will be March 21st and 22nd at 8 p.m. and March 23rd at 2 p.m. If anyone is interested in working production on the show, costume, set, lighting, tickets, etc., they should also come to the auditions. Again, the audition dates are January 8th, 9th, and 10th at 7 p.m. in the auditorium. As most of you probably noticed, Kim Ward is not with me here today, but we do have a standing by at La Salette. Kim? Thank you, Kim and Mike, for that look at La Salette. Also, thanks to the personnel of La Salette for their cooperation while we were there. In closing, Bill Dyan deserves special mention for his tremendous help with the show. Thanks, Bill. Well, that's our show for this week. We here at Channel 14 would like to wish you a happy holiday and a joyous new year. Hope to see you in 86, but remember that drinking and driving just don't mix. Have a good night. Thank you. Thank you.
And welcome back to another edition of What's Happening AHS. We have lots to say, so let's start with Kim.
Hello. Math team members meet Tuesday, January 14th at Bishop Pan. Make sure you pick up your practice problems.
Junior class officers and representatives, there is an important meeting Monday, January 13th after school to prepare for the fundraiser.
Freshman fundraiser prizes are in. You should see Mrs. Blythe in room 148D to collect yours.
Any girls tennis team member who has not yet ordered a warm-up jacket and wishes to do so may see Captains Holly Ladd or Sue Jinx by Friday, January 10th. Also, all members are asked to stop by room 224B by Friday.
Yearbooks may be ordered this week in the yearbook office, period 5, and during homeroom period. A $10 deposit is required.
Sophomores and juniors, you will soon be making course selections for next year. Have you considered taking child care and guidance? Thursday and Friday, January 9th and 10th, periods 1 through 7, for the first 20 minutes of each period, there will be an informational slide presentation in the mini auditorium. See your guidance counselor for a pass from your study.
There will be a New Year's dance January 10th at the Armory. Proceeds will benefit close-up, students going to Washington, and the varsity club. It will be held until 7:30 to 11 p.m. It's going to be a real good time.
Sophomores and juniors, the spring semester of Project Spotlight, the Thursday afternoon program at SMU, begins January 16th. If you are interested, please see your guidance counselor today.
All students, don't forget auditions for The Wizard of Oz will be held January 9th and 10th in the evening at 7 p.m. in the auditorium. There will be one after-school audition, which is Thursday, January 10th at 2:15. Don't forget to prepare either one slow or up-tempo song. It does not have to be from the show, but if it isn't, you must have your own sheet music.
Well, that's our show for this week. We here at Channel 14 would like to wish you a great new year. I'm Shelley Broder.
And I'm Kim Ward.
Thank you.
Welcome to another edition of What's Happening AHS. It's been a long time since we've been back, huh, Shel?
Yeah, it has. Did you catch that Patriots game?
Of course I did. That was great.
Ah, did we squish the fish?
We certainly did.
That was the best game. Congratulations, Patriots.
Okay. Get back.
Also, congratulations go to Bob Bischoff, Ted Morrissey, Andy Galasso, and Adam Newman for setting the state record in the two-mile relay at Harvard University on Sunday. They, along with Matt Manlove, clearing 6 feet 6 inches in the high jump, qualified for the Eastern Nationals at Princeton University in March. Good going, you guys.
All right. The Medical Explorer Post 82 will be meeting on January 16th at the Rice Webb Auditorium at Sturdy Memorial Hospital. Featured speaker will be Carol Curry, operating room head nurse. The meeting will be from 7 to 9 p.m.
Any juniors interested in the Massachusetts Advanced Studies Program from June 29th to August 9th, 1986 at Milton Academy, please see your guidance counselor before January 24th.
Students interested in seeing videos regarding financial aid or University of Massachusetts or Florida Southern College or New England Deaconess Hospital, etc., you should see Mrs. Collette in Career Resource Center.
Juniors and seniors, please consider the gift of life. Sign up in Cafeteria B2 this week to donate blood on next Friday, January 24th. You can make a difference.
Close-up meeting Tuesday in room 234B at 2 o'clock. All members should attend.
And sophomores, your class rings will be delivered 4 weeks from today. Any financial obligations from the wrapping paper sales must be taken care of before you can pick up your ring. Please see Bessie Denazi or one of your advisors with your payments today.
A key on a 26-inch chain has been found and may be picked up in the principal's office.
Well, that's our show for this week. Stay tuned for last Monday's school committee meeting coming up. I'm Shelley Broder.
And I'm Kim Ward.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.